All right, this video is being directed at you particularly, and I want you to see how much money I would rather do and give, who I would give to, rather than people like you on YouTube that say yoga is satanic and all this other crap. I mean, I'm that kind of asshole that I lay awake at night seeing who I can piss off, I guess, you know. Especially when I had the cops pat me down once and threatened violence and threatened to knock my ass out. Did a search on me because of he said, she said. Well, there's other reasons I was planning to do this anyway, but yes, I want to tell you that I'm out there and this is who I am. And, you know. All right, what's up, yins, guys? Time for another video. Get my hat on straight here of it. Anyway, some of you guys that already look in on my videos too, they never go viral or anything. And I know what you're going to say already too, a particular imagery. When I talk about some other subjects, I had a particular imagery in the corner. Oh no, there he goes again. But well, this is a thing that I want to do next. This was on my list. That particular imagery and the reason why I do it. And I am doing it to irritate particular people. And I have, so far, I haven't seen anybody on YouTube do anything like it yet. And there is a list of reasons for it. And another one of the reasons, too. There's so many reasons. It just takes me so damn long to get around to addressing either. There's so many that you can't address them all right away. But I should have made this video sooner because, yeah, YouTube, yeah, there's people on my list on YouTube. I want to piss off certain kinds of people on YouTube. And the imagery you're just seeing in the corner, too, which I don't know what the fuck any of yins guys really think of it because none of yins really say. But, yeah, it's time I talk about these people. And these people I want to irritate and flip them off, too, for that reason. Yeah, all these YouTubers that I've seen in the past, I've made sarcasms about in videos before. These ones that are on there on YouTube for God, and they're preaching for God, right? And there's so many different ones with PayPal and Patreon on their YouTube. And there was even a guy a long time ago that some guy was even asking for money. It says he goes, oh, I'm going to have to work a job if I don't get so much money given. And there's not enough given. And people called him on it in text, and he was saying, get off your high horse. This was some shit a long time ago because you see so many different ones where, well, a lot of the ones, I can list a few names, you know, in comments under this video. But I know I'm not saying every single one are bad. If they're talking about the bad stuff that's in the world, I'll listen to them or whatever. There's some better than others, to be fucking fair. But yeah, some of the ones that have these bigotries and different kind of things like that, which on my whole YouTube channel, the stuff that I do also do on purpose. These YouTubers that are going on there and seeing anything that resembles yoga, you're doing any kind of stretching or any kind of thing of strength, and if you're doing it from the core, it's satanic and that. And there's one saying that, yeah, there's actually a snake inside your body or whatever that you rely on. And quite frankly, I don't do that ohm shit or whatever, too. When I do splits and everything, I say different things other than ohm, especially if you were just learning. An amateur. Ohm is going to be the last thing you're going to be saying, but enough about that. But yeah, I do some of that to piss you guys off. And the imagery, put it this way. I'm trying to talk about an importance to you, or any of you people watching this too. I'm sick of different kind of religions. People on the fucking stage, the mega church on fucking, they want your money, and they have this fancy stage, fancy airplanes and cars, and they're in suits around tables. It was in suits in a fancy studio saying, oh, if we can just get $1,000 off of somebody, oh, we can have a water well for these people. And they're showing you the imagery and all that. And of course, you know they take your paychecks off the top. Meanwhile, you got people in a broken down town, like say you get towns like mine or even yours where the steel mills were gone years ago. And you got both white people, black people, white kids and black kids, you know, I mean, deteriorating town, a small charity and church that barely makes it, and they're trying to get toys for the kids and keep a food kitchen going and everything else. And then there's people out there that are very capable, unlike some people for health reasons they can't. And but can't even go out in a little weather or whatever. And then I preach things about being trusted too. And I am the one that deliberately, I can go around. People will tell you, oh, get a haircut. And any of you people like that want to tell me to get a haircut, you know, that my, whether you're the religious or the secular side or some kind of democratic socialist, or you're some kind of millennial that's not religious or whatever kind of liberal shit you say, and you're just in some skinny arms and legs and your t-shirts and shorts, you're like damn cargo pants and your t-shirts and shorts, and sport that stature that you wear your t-shirts and shorts in a way that fits just right, where it's flatter on that flatter in your physical stature, you know, in a way that, you know, you're literally, it's noble to appear like you're avoiding muscle development. Oh, well. Those kind, but with the smart mouths and everything like that, and like you know it all. And everybody got their little, what do you call it, virtues about how, what you're supposed to think or whatever. And they'll say, oh, a presumed drug, because you disagree with them. They accuse you, oh, get off the meth, get off the crack, and this and that, or you smoked or something retarded. They always play the drug card and everything else. And then, because they haven't got nothing else to damn say, and it's like, okay, you ask each one of these people, and even somebody makes comments on YouTube. Okay, when you say this, whatever, about me here or there, or about anybody else that disagrees with you or something you don't like, you try to ask them, okay, yeah, it's your opinion, right? But do you have a manifesto I can look at? You know, by what authority are you telling me something? Is it a religion or a god? Is it a conventional religion, or is it some other kind of religion? A communist daddy? What is, if it's not a god, is it some kind of moral platform or a behavior platform, like a neo-socialist, or is it neo-religious, or is it something millennial that, that now that it, your, an opinion about everybody should be that, is there a manifesto? If it's not a Bible, is there a manifesto that I can look at? You know, they never answer you back. And then if you say that to people in person out there in the world, they yell over top of you or mock you over top of you, don't let you finish a sentence, but then they say, let's say they're repetitive. So, you know, yeah, if you kind of, you're somebody that has a, some kind of a belief in God or whatever, and you think the world is corrupt. I had people text me about my videos about my takes on the gang stalking phenomena, that some of it's way out there, and then there's stuff, I'm trying to say there's reasonable things. And there are people that, despite what they see on my YouTube, that, you know, they see it, that they say, oh, God bless me. And they're being nice, and I'm like, oh, I'm like, you know what, I got to give them credit, because they're evidently, they're not judging me looking at whatever else I got on my YouTube. So you got to give them a little credit too. But I think a reason why I've put certain things that I want people to see, and like I said, if there's anybody of, you're white or black, you got long hair or dreads, I'm actually really kind of, if you have some kind of convictions one way or another that you want to do something to laugh and put people's face and to flip them off, I'm saying that it's not wrong. I'm saying that this, some of you people that are, I don't know, maybe Christians that are kind of decent that I can get along with, or if you're those other kind of people, I said that it's getting outdated to where the bit, you notice that since the dawn of time, the big religions, the authorities are always telling you everything you should do in secret, and God blesses you in secret. But now, more and more now, you get people on the political thing, in you're seeing on the news, respectable people embezzling and stealing, and all kind of people in all kind of different religious organizations. They're doing bad stuff, they're making the news, stealing, and even getting with underage kids and all kind of different scandals. I think you got to live your life in a way you can't be accused. I think put it that way. In a world that we're living in, you can actually be somebody that out there that maybe wore a suit and then went to some fancy church, watched a mega church on TV, and you may have went to a fancy church down in your city. There might be somebody out there that was given all this money, big bunch of income, in secret and writing checks, and maybe somebody got mad at you, a certain clique got mad, and all of a sudden, all that money you were given in secret, and all of a sudden, just because somebody's mad, accuse you of being on drugs and saying you probably steal. You know, it's an opening to slander somebody's name. You could be somebody that, I don't know, somebody sees this video, you could be somebody that might be in some fancy company that wouldn't give, that you see, oh, I have an attitude problem of some kind. Oh, yeah, you got a car, an SUV, right? And go, maybe even go to church or maybe not, and think I'm somebody with an attitude that has the money and you're giving it to some church, but somebody can get mad at you too and turn around. You know, you don't have your fancy job anymore. You get laid off. You have to take some shittier job or and see who your friends are. You know, but then some of us did get profiled. We're supposed to what? Get haircuts, do this or that. Or yeah, and say, yeah, maybe the police won't bother you and this or that. I think it's, okay, what I'm trying to say too, especially these fuckers on YouTube and the mega church or whatever, they're too much of fucking pussies to say go out in the fucking weather somewhere, which I think, even if you're not even religious, try it, it's kind of cool, you know. There's a part of it I kind of, an asshole like me got into it because it's like, in a weird way, the late George Carlin did say in some of his clips on YouTube that, man, people, that's their national pastime. They want to shop and eat. And then, yeah, he had a lot of things about how governments and that, they want obedient workers. And, oh, he could tell you a lot of things. I believe that. But yet at the same time, I'm watching all this and out there, and for some fucking reason, people are different for a certain time of the year. They're looking all happy. And then there's people out there that'll, you doing something for a charity and that, right? And some of the damnedest people, you're looking at what the hell some of them are putting in there and giving this money in that bucket there, right? And they're putting their trust in something, and then you're a part of that, and then, you don't know, people look at you, they're jealous, maybe you're making friends out there too, which you will, right? And, you know, they like to say, oh man, he's stealing money to buy drugs, man. But in reality, if people like you out there, man, all kind of people buying you burgers and fries, they trust you, so if any slanderers try to make any kind of lies or whatever, you know, even there's no proof of something, you know, that's how people are. They're like devils. Even if you're totally clean cut or whatever, whether, you know, man, people will just do that to try to destroy you. So, and then, hey, what I did too, wave to the camera. Boom. I think their time, any if you're anybody that's profiled, folks, I think it's time to go do something like that, because that money, it's all a bunch of fucking printed paper. I mean, they try to give people these jobs for all. They want to raise the minimum wage. And like I was saying to my brother on social media, yeah, like I told him how, you know, I got out of minimum wage, was working a job. I lived across from a restaurant. For a while, you know, the increase of minimum wage really didn't do anything for me then so much as the company. That when I was working for an agency, right, and it kind of get you on with the company, and they had a higher start pay. I got lucky, and they were given 50 cents a year, 50 cents an hour raises, and then they started giving little profit sharing bonuses. So anyway, the product I make, they were selling for several thousand dollars a set. Them pad, if you, anybody you know that's a truck driver, if you work, or if you've been behind any store, a loading dock where the trucks pull up against, right, there's pads all around that door, and the truck pulls up against there, keeps the weather out. I used to fucking make those. That company in an industrial park doesn't even exist anymore. But anyway, yeah, wages I got, even without the raises of minimum wage, they gave me better raises. My rent went up, you know. And I preach on and on about how you get over. Really, a lot of people don't like this too, the non-religious side. Oh, they hate you just as much as the religious fanatics that profile you at long hair and think you should be on jail. Oh, he's doing drugs. He's on dope. And it's like, then you get the other side that doesn't like that one side, that they're pissed at you because you don't buy the drugs that the old fogies that say everybody that has long hair that is accusing of doing drugs. And the very drugs you're accused of doing, the other side doesn't like you because you ain't buying them drugs or any cigarettes, or and what you're doing, your costs go up, so you just, some of us don't have any habits. Restaurant across the street from me, I mean, that was the first thing I did there, working 10 hours and didn't want to cook. Take your shower, your day's shot, go out, eat somewhere. Can be a cafe too, you know, a little TV on. And maybe around the corner, there's this place that, like, it's not a bar. They'll be like, oh, in so many words, this is not a bar. They don't say it, but it's understood. This is not a bar. If you want to go and drink all this beer one after another, you go down the street. There was a cafe that serves beer and good food. You smell the food in there. That's the normal way to be for me. But, and no matter what you believe in, what you don't believe in, I'm all for, I'm one of them people that people think they're shit. And they'll go and believe their shit. And they'll even have a shrine, even when you disprove them. You got these people that literally will make an altar and a shrine in their fucking house, or make a temple dedicated to the belief that so-and-so is on crack. And it's like, you know. In this video, I have a saying about giving a rat's ass. It's kind of funny that, how can you give a rat's ass? The ass of the rat isn't yours to give. So let the rat keep his ass. Or you can pick up a rat in tandem to somebody else's ass first. And yes, you're giving a rat's ass. And if the other person wants to accept the rat ass first, to give a rat's ass, you're sort of offering up the rat's ass. And it's up to the other person if he wants to accept. So I'll have another saying too, that in some certain things, that if a rat's ass should really be offered or even given about a particular subject. So that's what I say about tolerance. There are certain things you can say. Sometimes you give a shit. There's some aspect, and I also have a thing where I say there's certain aspects of giving a shit or giving a fuck. It's not that I don't give a shit or give a fuck. It's there's some aspects of giving a shit or giving a fuck that I don't give a shit or a fuck about. And at any given time, when and where should a rat's ass be given, or a fuck be given, or a shit be given, or even offered? You know what I mean? So yeah, we have that motto there about when you tolerate something or other person tolerates you. That's where I say, let the rat keep his ass. You know what I mean? The rat's ass isn't yours to give. Or is not mine to give. Let the rat keep his ass. It belongs to the rat. Let the rat keep his ass. So that kind of tells you something about tolerance. You know, live and let live, even if you do it in a smirky, smart-ass kind of a way. If you've gotten this far in this video, and matter of fact, this video is so fucking long, that I need to cut a snippet from the end of this video and post it as a separate video if you got this damn far. Okay, this really is the end of the video this time, honest. Okay, here I go. See you guys next video. See you next time.
And then they even keep repetitive calls to the police. And maybe one time in your life, you know, you'll have the police come to you, threaten violence. And yeah, you better spread eagles so they can pick your pockets. Then they never bother you again. They don't find anything because you guys all know, you know, people aggravate that shit. They keep calling and calling. Then eventually, you know, that happens. And they were hoping that a lot of people, they call the cops on fine shit. It's not what this whole video is completely about. But people play that, they play them games. You know what I mean? They're hoping to find something. Because somebody gets kickbacks when they catch so many people and collect money and fines. Say you can be a total clean record. Nothing on your record. And if they try to say that you resisted the pat down, which is supposed to be fucking unconstitutional, you can get felony charges, or they can go to court. You can get fines and everything else that people want to collect. You know, if they feel like saying, well, yeah, you put up some trouble, and then they somebody that's maybe a color and has dreads, or somebody like hair like mine, maybe, oh, they maybe they're that they want to beat on, and they think that, oh, it'll be in another day's work. They think that they're going after somebody that they presume maybe have some other kind of a record, and nobody's going to believe, you know. But once in a while, it's not the case, and some people like me will use the internet and retaliate, you know, act all nice and walk with a smirk on my face and retaliate over the internet. But anyway, yeah, you're going to have that. But anyway, you know, not to get off the subject here, I says, you know, rather than your stupid, I want to direct this shit right straight to you idiots that, oh, whatever you do like that looks like yoga is all satanic and all this other bullshit that you go on YouTube and you got fools giving you money on YouTube. You're making money on YouTube saying this shit. I'm saying to any of you that even saw that shit on YouTube, what I believe in doing is that, yeah, I want to flaunt this shit in your faces too, that I want to be the first one on YouTube, but I want to be known out there to you fuckers out there, you stupid religious fuckers out there that people are giving you money. Did I want not to pat myself on the back or any of you kind of decent Christians, it's unbiblical, you shouldn't do that. I'm one of them assholes that will go pretty far out of spite, and I want you to know this, that a handful, a hundred, say, and I want to set things straight too, that say you work for an organization once in a while on the holidays like I do. Yes, they do pay you. It's not a paycheck, and it's you don't get a W-2 for it. It's lunch money. Did anybody, that's another thing they accuse you of. Yeah, you want to do an extra job because you can't hold a job because you want money for dope. That's another. There are so many fucking reasons that you can't make it all on a fucking YouTube. Yes, and I fucking swear too. Yes, I could do that and go beyond the call for people that, yes, I'm a fucking, yeah, I'm the one of the biggest fucking assholes in the world. But yes, I actually care about people that, you know, the homeless and whoever anybody is, that want to get some kind of stuff from a food kitchen. And I care about some of these kids, maybe get a little toys, both the white kids and the black kids. And maybe they won't, they'll grow up and try to have a little hope. And maybe they can eventually make something out of ourselves that's maybe a little bit better and not turn into such assholes like us or worse, and don't wind up in prison. Because I'm saying that that's what they want for the kids, whether it's both the black or the white kids. It's a fucking racket. They want crime. Even Henry Rollins mentioned that in his Everything. It's like, I think you can order it online or DVD. They take it off of YouTube because it's, but if you want to look into it and get it, it's worth it. Even Henry Rollins said that. They don't want to really solve crime. They want it because somebody gets kickbacks from it. They really don't want any kids or anybody to turn out good. They want them to be on antidepressants. They want them to be in the jail systems in and out. They want them to be in the rehab systems. And now any people that smoke a little marijuana because they're sick, I understand that. Nothing wrong with that. But they want you to do now, and whether it's that, they want you to be a slave to it because they're putting shit in it. Maybe they want to get you addicted to it. I still think that somewhere along the line, yeah, it's for the sick. But I suspect that if they're not doing it now, they could be putting shit in that too, to gradually, all of a sudden, you'll start having other things wrong with you, sicknesses. Anything that government advocates and uses so that their buddies can get kickbacks. But then, you know, when you buy some kind of things, you can listen to Hendrix, listen to some reggae or old Black Sabbath or Bob Marley or Led Zeppelin. Back in the time, you know, you smoke some marijuana, it was harmless, right? Even some of them things, you watch who you buy for, you don't know what they're putting in it, you know, watch who you buy from. Then you got all these pills now, people are lacing all kind of shit, people are dying. And you got our governor over here, you know, opioid epidemic that they created, you know, part of it's trying to kill some of the population. And some of the people they claim are arresting, they got ones that are paying protection money. They let it slide, and they got to get the ones that ain't protecting or protection money. You get their kickbacks. And then all of a sudden now, like, you get governors wanting to balance a budget. They got to buy all this Narcan, pretend to be compassionate, and buy this all this Narcan, bam. Oh, man, I'm so regard. Look at me. I have all this regard for life, man. And all these people dying of this stuff. Oh, that fake show of compassion. And then just like the president of the Future of Freedom Foundation said, they're the biggest purveyors of it. So now all of a sudden they're arresting doctors and all that shit. And all these other people over prescribing because they got to fucking throw somebody to the wolves. And again, uh-oh, man, we got to, just like some of you people on YouTube, both white and black Christians that I kind of was looking at that I support. You know, a couple of us, you know about Bohemian Grove. We know about all this other shit and some good ones out there that talking about these YouTubers that are both good, white gentlemen and black gentlemen that I've been looking at. I can say some names. They kind of got it nailed, different celebrities that are all involved in shit. And I like the word that they're using. There's how they sacrifice particular people, you know. No different what they did at Epstein. Oh, hung himself. Yeah, right. And, yeah, all the over prescribing of drugs or whatever, you know what I mean? The biggest purveyors of it are the ones acting like they're the most compassionate in their... Throw a few people to the wolves, you know what I mean? Like the video, the story of your enslavement. Everybody is basically cattle, and they just play these games to give you the illusion that they're fighting for something, and give you the illusion of freedom, and then they grace you with the liberties you're actually graced with, just to give you enough of an illusion of freedom, and they're only you're graced with these freedoms to a certain point, but. Yeah, it's a lot of shit that, you know, you're sick and tired of, but one of the things I say, too, that I'm throwing a few other subjects in there, but directing this at some of you, that I'm saying that reason why I'm saying that is, some of you, I want to see that, I want people to see firsthand that some of you out there doing that shit on YouTube that I want to flaunt to you where I would rather throw a whole bunch of money that no fucking way you would get. You think I'm going to get a haircut and give you fuckers some kind of damn money? Ian, believe yoga is satanic, fuck you, you know?
Oh,